Our next extract is from the last musical from the pen of Gowans and Larson, and is entitled The Meeting. This was first presented on the 29th of June 1990, and some of the cast here tonight were present at that premiere. The two Johns took a standard Salvation Army meeting and looked at stories associated with those that were attending. There was also a musical within a musical, something that they did on more than one occasion. This extract looks at the story of Sarah, who is about to become a soldier, or for the layperson, a member of the Salvation Army that evening.
Say, Sarah, your father would turn in his grave if he could see you in that uniform.
Well, I don't see why he should. After all, you were wearing an army uniform the day he fell in love with you.
Sarah, you've no right.
He told me so himself. You came into the Red Lion with an armful of war cries and bam, that was it. He was caught, hook, line and sinker.
But that was before. Before I knew what those Sally Army people were really like. Take that Ethel, for example, the one that runs the Home League. The way she ran roughshod over my feelings. The way she treated me.
Oh, Mother, it's nothing important. Ethel doesn't hold it against you.
Nothing important? Nothing important, she says. I'll have you know those Home League cups were sacred. And Ethel had no right to go loaning them to the over 60s club. At least that's not that home.
That was 9 years ago. It's a storm in a teacup.
I don't care if it was 100 years ago. I'll never forgive her, never. It was Mrs. Major Angel that put me in charge of those Home League crocs, and Ethel had got no right to interfere.
Ethel was only trying to be helpful.
And now you have to go and join them. It's treachery, Ethel, it's treachery.
Oh, Mother, don't upset yourself like that. Now, come on, pop your coat on. It's time for the meeting.
I'm not sure I'm going. I haven't been there for years and I vowed never to darken their doors again.
But you promised Alex.
Oh, Alex. He's the only real Christian amongst them. A promise is a promise, I suppose.
That's what you've always taught me.
But everybody will stare at me.
Well, stare right back.
Oh, all right, all right. But we're coming home before the end, mind. And that's a promise too.
Oh, Mother.
All who wish to become soldiers of the Salvation Army are required to sign the Articles of War. In so doing, they testify that they worship God as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. They have accepted Jesus Christ as Saviour and Lord. They desire to fulfil their membership of this church on earth as a soldier of the Salvation Army. They affirm their belief in the Bible as the Word of God and their acceptance of the Salvation Army Articles of Faith. They declare their determination by God's help to be true soldiers of the Salvation Army. Do you declare in the presence of God in this congregation that you undertake by the help of the Holy Spirit to live and work as a true soldier of Jesus Christ of the Salvation Army, according to the witness and promises you have made today? If so, if you would raise your right hand and say, I do.
I do.
In the name of the Lord whom we love and serve, I accept your declaration and you as a soldier of this corps of the Salvation Army. Before we hear Wenyam's testimony, I invite you to welcome her as the newest soldier of the Salvation Army.
Commit to fight and commit to follow. I want to be faithful, Lord Jesus, to you. Commit to go where you ask me to go and do what you want me to do. Your servant, and yet so incredibly free. I choose to be just what you want me to be.
We're proud of Sarah and delighted that she has chosen to become a soldier in the Salvation Army. Very soon this meeting will be over. Once again we have met with the Lord.
Hallelujah!
We have been strengthened and encouraged.
Hallelujah!
Some of us have been turned upside down. But it is with confidence that we can face the future. For it is with Christ that we go into the future.
Hallelujah!